welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. Over the last few years, the world has witnessed an upsurge in technology developments, especially when we talk of artificial intelligence. Countries these days are focusing more and more on leveraging this technology because of its transformative nature. Both in terms of economy as well as societal needs, artificial intelligence has the potential to provide large incremental value. In fact, AI is predicted to contribute $15.7 trillion to the global economy by the year 2030. It has the potential to add $957 billion to the Indian economy by the year 2035. In fact, the government also believes that artificial intelligence in different forms can help India achieve the $5 trillion benchmark over the next 5 years. Based on the AI-powered technology, a Samsung lab has unveiled an artificial human called Neon, which can converse and also sympathize like real people. So on this edition of In Depth, we'll tell you all about this artificial human, the technology that allows for the creation of such customized digital beings, and how different it is from the other humanoids that have been created in the past. Besides, we'll also talk about the scope and progress of artificial intelligence in our country. Well, the idea of artificial humans or machines acting as human beings has been a part of our imagination for several decades. From films to books to several other forms of fiction, humanoids have been shown as having emotions, helping human beings, and also at times working on their own. That imagination is now very soon set to become a reality. With Samsung Star Labs unveiling Neon, an artificial human with emotions that can give lifelike responses like real people. Making science fiction a reality, Samsung has unveiled the world's first artificial human, Neon. It was launched by Samsung's Star Labs Research Group at Consumer Electronics Show in Vegas on the 7th of January. At the CES 2020, Star Labs demonstrated 6 avatars of Neon based on people from different walks of life, including a yoga instructor, a banker, a K-pop star, a news anchor, and a model, among others. Samsung Technology and Advanced Research Labs describe Neon as a virtual being that looks and behaves like a real human with the ability to show emotions and intelligence. Pranav Mistry, Neon CEO and head of Star Labs, said that Neons will be our friends, collaborators and companions, continually learning, evolving and forming memories from their interactions.
Neon is a product launched by Samsung Technology and Advanced Research Labs, STAR. It was launched at CES 2020 on this Monday, and it's a computationally generated virtual being which is supposed to look and behave like a human. It's not a human being, but it's supposed to look and behave like that. So it is expected to have intelligence, it is expected to have memory. It's probably a digital embodiment of a human being. That could be a close definition of that. What it is not, it's not a virtual assistant. So what you would have seen is things like, say, Amazon Alexa or Google Assistant. It's not that. So it will not give you all kinds of information, but it's supposed to behave like a human being. So it will, based on its interaction, it will learn about human emotions. It will have a memory of how it will interact with you. And Neon is expected to do specific tasks that requires a human touch.
Star Labs has made it clear that Neon should not be confused with or commercial AIs like Google Assistant and Amazon Alexa. Neon can be understood as a video chatbot that can learn people's preferences and respond to their queries in a lifelike way, aiming to deliver a deeply personalized experience. As per Samsung, Neons are not AI assistants but are more like us. They are independent but virtual living beings that can show emotions and also learn from experiences. Unlike AI assistants, Neons do not know it all. They're also not an interface to the internet. The Neons understand Hindi, Spanish, and several other languages. Neons will have different looks and attitudes as per requirement. Each Neon is also expected to be unique
with its own personality. Neons will be available for companies and people to license. Neons developers claim that the artificial human can be used as yoga instructors, TV anchors, spokespersons, movie actors, financial advisors, and much more. They can also simply be companions and friends with their human-like qualities.
You know, 10 years ago, we saw, you know, robots created by Honda, Asimo, which could walk like human, which could, you know, speak few words like human. And then we saw the age of digital assistants. You had, you know, Google Assistant, you had Siri, which could not only do the personalized tasks for you, but which could also, in a way, were AI empowered to reply to certain things, not only by, you know, by what was there already inside their knowledge, but could, like, you know, analyze certain things and can give, you know, replies which were full of cognitive intelligence, which could, like, you know, which could sound like human replies. This was called artificial intelligence or artificial thinking or artificial mimicking of human mind.
The neon artificial humans are powered by two-pronged technology. The first, called Core R3, stands for reality, real-time and responsive. The Core R3 technology makes the neons respond quickly and also in a lifelike manner. The time taken by Core R3 technology to respond to queries is less than a few milliseconds. The second part is called Spectra, which is responsible for intelligence, learning, emotions and memory. The launch of the artificial human has sparked the debate of technology going too far yet again. Star Labs, in a statement, said that neons are not looking to replace human jobs, but rather enhance the customer service interactions. Questions are also being raised about whether the technology could be used for deepfakes or videos manipulated to show real people doing or saying something they did not. Trying to allay fears, Star Labs said that Core R3 secures data by using state-of-the-art security protocols, and Neon will also never share private data without permission. It is still some time for Neon to turn into reality. For now, the Star Labs is planning to introduce a beta version of Neon later this year, which will be available for select partners on license. With inputs from Bipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
We'll take a short break here on the program, but on the other side, we'll tell you how different Neon is from the other humanoids that have been created in the past. Do stay with us.
For centuries, Delhi has been known for waterworks, given the vast number of kingdoms in the city. Among the earliest ones was a dam at Anangpur village, the city believed to be built by Rajput king Anangpal Tomar. This unique Indian hydraulic engineering structure was built around 8th century, running 50 meters long and standing 7 meters high. This dam was more of a water harvesting structure meant to store rainwater during the monsoon season. Located close to Anangpur village lies Surajkund, the waterworks which is regarded as among Delhi's first organized reservoir. Built in the shape of rising sun with an eastward arc, it's enclosed with a steep embankment made in semicircular shape of stepped stones. These reservoirs took care of need of the city at the time of the shortage of water, given Delhi's topography and warm weather spells. Also, once existed a magnificent sun temple near the Surajkund reservoir.
What are some key legislations introduced in Rajya Sabha? Some of the key legislations introduced in Rajya Sabha are the Indecent Representation of Women Bill 1986, the Indian Succession Bill 1991, and the Marriage Laws Bill 1999.
Rabindranath Tagore was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913 for his book Gitanjali. In 1950, he composed the music and lyrics for India's national anthem, Jana Gana Mana. And when Bangladesh became independent in 1971, they chose Tagore's song, Amar Shonar Bangla, as its national anthem. Tagore's life and works have made him a cultural icon, studied the world over, even into the 21st century.
Countries around the world are becoming increasingly aware of the potential economic and social benefits of developing and also applying artificial intelligence. For example, China and the UK estimate that 26% and 10% of their GDPs respectively in 2030 will be sourced from AI-related activities and businesses. In India too, the artificial intelligence industry is booming. In its recent AI research report, Accenture estimates AI to boost India's annual growth rate by 1.3 percentage points by the year 2035. More details of the progress made by India in this sector in our next report.
Artificial intelligence has a huge scope in India as it has been a growing hub for business and ranks among the most lucrative investment destinations for technology transactions worldwide. Despite being a late entrant in the field, India has ranked 13th out of 200 countries with respect to the development of artificial intelligence. Across the world, AI is emerging as a new factor of production, augmenting the traditional factors of production like labor, capital, and innovation, and technological changes captured in total factor productivity. AI has the potential to overcome the physical limitations of capital and labor and opens up new sources of value and growth. From the perspective of an economic impact, artificial intelligence has the potential to drive growth by enabling intelligence automation, which is the ability to automate complex physical world tasks that require adaptability and agility across industries. Labor and capital augmentation, which is enabling humans to focus on parts of their role that add the most value, complementing human capabilities and improving capital efficiency, and innovation diffusion, that is, propelling innovations as it diffuses through the economy. AI is expected to boost India's annual growth rate by 1.3 percentage points by the year 2035, according to estimates released by NASSCOM. Further, the technology has the potential to add $957 billion growing with 15% of India's current gross value in the same year, with agriculture, education, healthcare, and infrastructure as the primary sectors benefiting from it. In 2017, 4% of the country's GDP came from the leaps made by digital products and services created using AI and IoT. According to predictions from Microsoft India, this number is expected to shoot up to 60% by 2021. Indian IT companies have already established themselves as pioneering technology solution providers to the world, and India could build on this model to provide AI as a service as well.
Key enabler in us solving some of the biggest challenges that we have. while from a financial perspective, there are several sectors where this AI will benefit and it will improve the bottom line of several companies. From a government perspective or from a broader nation perspective, the challenges in ensuring appropriate healthcare coverage to the entire country, having high quality education, having advanced support to our farmers, etc., are some of the priority areas for us.
In order to leapfrog to greater heights of development, India has established some state-of-the-art facilities dedicated to the research and application of advanced technologies like AI.
It could be used as an instrument to leverage and try to exponentially solve some of the biggest challenges that we have. For example, if we have to make sure that quality cancer diagnosis is available across the country, we are able to diagnose all cases of tuberculosis across the country, whether we can make sure that we address the issue of low child birth weight by creating diagnosis tools and then acting upon it. So gathering this kind of intelligence, augmenting the limited capability that we may have in healthcare, in education, etc., is what the future for us in AI for the foreseeable future would be. And that is where we have put in a lot of effort in trying to understand where to focus, what are the problem areas we should curate. This could be in healthcare, agriculture, it could be in financial inclusion, and how do we build capabilities in it.
In its working paper, National Strategy for Artificial Intelligence, AI for All, the Niti Aayog proposed a two-tier approach for achieving India's AI aspirations. It involves the establishment of centers of research excellence in AI and international centers for transformational AI. The centers of research excellence in artificial intelligence will be hubs of knowledge generation for academics, while international centers for transformational AI will leverage private sector collaboration with industry practitioners to translate research evidence into social good for all. In addition, a cloud computing platform called Eravat is also being set up. Besides, AI labs are also being set up by the Indian telecom companies.
Perspective, we released India's National Strategy for Artificial Intelligence in June 2018. So we are one of the few countries that now has a defined strategy for artificial intelligence. We have been in the process of building out a program for implementing that recommendation, and that has already been approved by the Minister of Finance Minister and Ministry of Finance, and we are in the final stage of getting approval for that. In parallel, we have been also working on several initiatives where we are seeing, look, AI is important, and this is how we demonstrate whether it can be used in areas that are important to us. So, for example, we have been working in cancer diagnosis by building an imaging biobank. We are working in diabetic retinopathy by trying to use technology to diagnose the onset of diabetic retinopathy in patients. Then we are building products which could be used in agriculture, which is advanced assaying of farmer produce, could be in giving agronomic advisory to farmers, which could be, say, imminent pest attack, the water, the farm moisture level, etc. is what.
In the area of core research publications in AI, India ranks third in the world with 12,135 documents behind China and the US. Conversely, India stands at rank 9 in terms of the number of AI specialists, with 555, as 22,400 people worldwide were regarded as the top talent of AI. Beyond the economic impact, artificial intelligence has the potential to provide large incremental value to a wide range of sectors like healthcare, agriculture, education and skilling, bringing about a positive transformation in the quality of life and also access of choice to a large section of the country. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Robots, intelligent machines, advanced software, artificial intelligence and neural networks have been a result of the fascination. And today, we are at a stage where all these have become a reality. From just a vision to actual advancements, we have indeed come a long way. Today, artificial intelligence is a fascinating wing of science and technology that is slowly and gradually shaping our future.
The there are many new technological innovations that are changing our lives. But artificial intelligence may present the most exciting changes. AI includes machine learning as well as deep learning. On one hand, machine learning algorithms are helping businesses evolve. And on the other hand, speech recognition, image processing techniques, and fingerprint patterns are taking the world by storm. We use gadgets that are intelligent and make our everyday tasks easy. For example, Alexa can remind you about your daily appointments, keep a check on your grocery list, play your favorite music when you need, read news, and even play some brain games. It is like a human companion. It is not human, but has human-like capabilities.
In terms of artificial intelligence, we have seen there has been tremendous progress in the last 10-15 years, more specifically in areas like machine learning and deep learning. Also because the computation aspect has become far more advanced and far more cheaper. And we have seen that there has been a lot of data, there's a lot of information, and the kind of algorithms that have been written are very advanced in nature. So a lot of tasks that, again, that are defined as narrow AI, which is computer vision, which is looking at a specific set of information and bringing intelligence out of it, has become very, very easy for computers to do and AI algorithms to do at near or in some cases even better than human beings. For example, recognition of a particular anomaly in a cancer radiology image is almost like human being nowadays.
In general, artificial intelligence is going to change almost every aspect of daily life. While we will look for ways to make use of it in the homes, AI will also be adopted by local and state governments as well as by the business sector. Self-driving cars are already beginning to make their way on the roadways, but we can expect this technology to advance considerably in the coming years. By incorporating AI technology into robotics, it can be used to give us greater strength, longevity, and endurance. The application of this technology is really aimed at helping the disabled. Cybernetic limbs that can communicate with the brain can become almost as useful as natural limbs. Robots with AI technology can take on dangerous jobs and carry out activities that poses health risks to people. Tech industry is planning AI-driven applications, allowing machines to recognize faces to complete transactions. Credit cards and driver's license may be linked to one's face, allowing pattern recognition devices to know a person instantly. This can make everyday transactions far more efficient and safe. Research is already underway to develop new software applications that use AI to help doctors diagnose and treat patients. The ever-growing capabilities of artificial intelligence allow it to analyze large amounts of financial data in order to make predictive decisions in areas like the stock market. The 2020 Consumer Electronics Show, the world's premier tech show, has on display several products related to artificial intelligence, augmented and virtual reality, and robotics. A superintelligent AI is by definition very good at attaining its goals, whatever they may be, so it's important to ensure that its goals are aligned with the humankind. As artificial intelligence continues to evolve, these innovations are likely to be overshadowed by even greater advancements. However, AI can never replace humans. A machine may think on its own, but it still works on instructions given by humans. With inputs from Vipul Agarwal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Let's now talk about humanoids or human robots. Been in development for several decades, humanoids have transformed artificial intelligence tremendously. First revealed in the year 1927, most advanced human robots today are transforming every walk of our lives. We leave you with this report that talks about the evolution of humanoids over the years.
Humanoid is a robot with a body shape built to reflect the human body. Generally, humanoid robots have a torso with a head, two arms and two legs. But many modern humanoid robots are only based on the human body from the waist up. Interestingly, the word robot comes from a Czech word robota, which means forced labor. It was first used by Czech writer Karel Čapek to denote a fictional character in the 1920s play Rozum's Universal Robots. Herbert Telibor was the first ever humanoid robot. Built by Ron Wensley in 1927, the robot could lift the receiver to accept a telephone call and control simple processes by operating switches. While the robot did not have the ability to speak when it was first created, it later learned to say two simple sentences. It had the ability to listen with a sensitive microphone placed close to the telephone receiver and could respond to actions based on sound and pitch. The company that created Telibor later went on to create Electro the Moto-Man in 1937, which many people consider to be the first humanoid robot. In 1961, the first digitally operated and programmable robot, the Unimate, was installed on the General Motors assembly line. It was used to lift hot pieces of metal from a die-casting machine and stack them. The Unimate became the basis of many of the industrial robots still used in assembly lines today. IBM created a computer known as Deep Blue in 1996 with one of the first instances of artificial intelligence. The computer was designed to play chess, and on 11th of May 1997, it beat world chess champion Garry Kasparov. Sophia is world's first robot citizen, introduced to the United Nations on 11th October 2017. Released by Hong Kong-based Hanson Robotics in 2016, Sophia is a social robot with silicon skin, with the ability to interact with people and also display more than 50 facial expressions. With very expressive doe brown eyes and long fluttery eyelashes, along with a sense of humor, Sophia was designed to look like the British actress Audrey Hepburn. Sophia was granted Saudi Arabian citizenship, making her the first humanoid robot ever to have a nationality. Since she was granted citizenship, Sophia has attended several interviews, conferences, and is now one of the world's most popular humanoids. Japan's Osaka University's latest humanoid robot, Erika, was built in the appearance of a woman. The robot started to work on a TV channel in Japan in the year 2018 and was widely accepted by the Japanese.
You know, in last 2-3 years, we saw another evolution that, you know, why not create a humanoid which could act like human, which could look like human, and which could also think like human. So we saw Sophia, which a robot which got the first citizenship in Saudi Arabia. But, you know, still you could very well at the first instance could figure out that, you know, this was a robot. The facial expressions were trying to mimic humans, but they could not exactly look like humans. And then, you know, since it was trained on so many models of knowledge sets, it could mimic human mind, it could think, it could show emotions, but then there were limitations that, you know, you could figure out. You know, if you ask something like how's the weather, they might reply. But if you ask something like, should I have tea in weather when I'm not, you know, wearing a sweater or something, or why I'm feeling so sad? So those sort of replies would, you know, make you think that probably this is a machine which is trying to mimic a human mind.
In recent times, countries around the world are becoming increasingly aware of the potential economic and social benefits of developing and applying artificial intelligence. For example, China and the United Kingdom estimate that 26% and 10% of their GDPs respectively in the year 2030 will be sourced from AI-related activities and businesses. Humanoids have been gaining popularity in India as well for quite some time. Indian startups as well as the government are working at a rapid pace to integrate new age technologies. According to reports, sales of industrial robots in India reached a new record of 4,771 new units installed in 2018, which is an increase of 39% compared to the previous year. At 2 kilo and 2 feet tall, Manav is India's first 3D printed humanoid robot. Mitra is India's first indigenously built humanoid capable of interacting with humans smartly. Robocop, developed by a Hyderabad-based startup, is a police robot to assist in handling the law, order, and also traffic management. Initially, the major aim of artificial intelligence for humanoids was for research purposes. Modern-day humanoids are developed to carry out different human tasks and occupy different roles in the employment sector. However, experts now worry about humanoid robots being able to replace jobs. Another disadvantage to humanoid robots could be the price, depending on how advanced the robot is. For example, a Simo created by Honda in 2000, considered to be the most advanced robot, is priced at $2,500. As scientists and engineers around the world are developing more advanced humanoids every day, can be traced back to be in fact an artist. Legendary Italian artist Leonardo da Vinci is credited to have created the first ever robot in 1495. Clad in German-Italian medieval armor suit, it could perform a lot of human functions like sitting, standing, and walking. It is partially a result of Leonardo's anatomical research in the canon of proportions as described in the Vitruvian Man. But to understand the modern world of humanoid robots, it is important to look at the comprehensive evolution of robotics from 400 BC, which is believed to be the real starting point of robotics when mathematician Archytas created the first steam-powered mechanical bird. In its best run, it flew approximately 200 meters before running out of steam. Not only was this the first ever robot ever created, it was also one of the first instances of scientific research into flying. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.